Hey everyone, it's Ryan Mentz, and in today's video, I want to quickly touch on a few things that wildlife photographers should know about social media and Instagram in particular when it comes to scrolling through your feed and seeing amazing images day in and day out, and the negative thoughts that they can stir about your own progress and your own wildlife portfolio. First, let's talk about the depth of content from wildlife photographers. And the thing you need to know is that people will post multiple photos from just one shooting opportunity with an animal, and sometimes even from the same continuous burst in an action sequence. They take these photos and spread them out over weeks or months, depending on the depth of their catalog, and that allows them to have a constant stream of images, even if they aren't out shooting amazing moments day in and day out, like you might be led to believe they are. The same idea goes for travel photography and wildlife trips, so one trip that only lasts a few days can be behind 20 or 30 posts that are spread over multiple months, and it can kind of make it seem like they're living this jet set lifestyle when really it was all just from that one trip. On top of that, it's not uncommon for wildlife photographers to share a photo more than once, because our audience is always growing and the platform's attention span is counted in seconds. It's really not a bad idea to reshare older photos. Now, this is all taken in consideration against the fact that this person might have been doing wildlife photography for 10 or more years, and so they really do have a sizable portfolio to pull everything from. So it's really not fair to yourself to compare yourself to that if you've only been shooting for a few seasons. Next, I want to talk about the quality of a wildlife photographer's work and post-processing. You should know it's everywhere. Some photos require more work than others, and the better the photographer is at editing, the less you would think that it was retouched at all. The best retouched photos aren't the ones that you see and think, wow, look at that processing, how'd they do it? It's the ones where you didn't think that processing was needed at all because the photo just grabs you, and there's nothing heavy-handed about it, and the photographer didn't make the processing the focal point of the image. But that's rarely ever the truth, right? There's tonal adjustments and color enhancements and branch removal and other cloning, and there's heavy cropping, and especially with the heavy cropping because Instagram makes it so easy to get away with, but these are things that are happening everywhere all the time in your feed. The photos you're taking and seeing straight out of camera might actually be closer than you think to being on par with what these other people are shooting and seeing straight out of camera. And the difference might just be in those stealthy editing skills. Now to clarify, I'm not saying that editing is an untruthful process, and I do it 100% of the time myself, but I do think it's one of those hidden truths in photography where beginners just really aren't fully aware of how deep and how much of it there is, and that creates unrealistic expectations of in-camera skill, and that just starts a whole lot of unwarranted frustration. Third, and probably the most important thing to remember, is that every great photographer was once a terrible photographer. And so with that, that kind of leads me into talking about the community aspect of Instagram for wildlife photography. In general, I find that many wildlife photographers are going to be happy to help with information and teaching as far as photography techniques or animal behaviors, gear questions or recommendations, and traveling tips, and so much more. So many of us are bonded by our passion for animals that I usually see that fly above any sort of ego-driven competition between photographers. So if you're scrolling through your feed and you're seeing all these amazing photos that are making your jaw drop, and kind of bringing in some negative thoughts as well, instead of just hanging your head and feeling that self-doubt, I think you should ask them a question about something in the photo that you wish you could achieve too, or just a question in general at all, because you want to replace those empty negative thoughts with information that you can actually use. And I find that most photographers are going to be more than happy to help you, and they're going to be flattered that you asked, honestly. So with that, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.